Hello and welcome to C# programming project based learning course. In this course, we are going to design records management application using C# programming and MySQL database programming. Since start of the course, I am describing the records management application but have not shown you anything in runtime. So in this lecture, I will give you a demo of the application in runtime so that you will know that what will be our end product. So now going to the Microsoft Visual Studio 2015 environment and then clicking the start button. Now upon clicking the start button, now minimizing this. This is our login form. This is the login page of our records management application, which is designed for the voting system and which is designed using C# programming and MySQL database along with the backend MySQL database. So here you are clearly it is clearly showing that it consists of two buttons. One is the login and one is the sign up account button. By entering the your national identification number as your user ID, if you are registered in this, if you have a registered account, if you have already signed up, then you can enter your user ID and then password, and then upon clicking the login, then the main form will be shown. And if your account does not exist, then in this voting system, in this application, then you can create your account by clicking the sign up button. Now let us click the sign up button to create an account. While clicking the sign up button, this is the polling staff registration form. It consists of two other pages, but I will give you the detailed demo of this polling staff registration form when we are going to design this form. Now upon clicking the back, we will go back to the main form. Now this is the, now upon clicking the logout, then upon, now if you have already created an account, and then on entering your user ID, let me enter my user ID as I have already registered with this application. In this I have already registered, and then entering your password, and upon clicking on the login, so that all my details are shown, data account details, my staff ID, my name Muhammad Ishtiaq Khan, father name, gender, position officer, birth of date, and that's all the address. Next, as I have already discussed in the previous lecture, that various links are present there to and in these are the buttons, and the purpose of these buttons to carry you to the other pages of this application. Now as I am the staff member and I want to update my profile, then upon clicking on this update staff profile, that's the polling staff registration form update staff profile page. Now going back to the main menu. Now if you want to create a voter profile, then upon clicking on the create voter profile button, let us click on, and it's the voter registration form. Here you can enter the personal information, and also general information will be entered, but I will show everything, a detailed demo of each page. These are the various pages: voter registration form, create voter profile, update voter profile. These are the various modules, and when we are designing these modules, then I will show you the detailed demo. So going back to the main menu, now if I want to update the voter profile, then upon clicking on the update voter profile button, and it will carry us to the update voter registration form, update voter profile form, and here we can update by entering the candidate ID and then searching for it and then updating it and then clicking on the update button and then saving it. So you can easily update all the records of the voter. Also, this is the create candidate profile. Here you can create the candidate profile and also allot a symbol to him using this candidate registration. This is a candidate registration form. Here you can enter all the details of the candidates. Now going back to the main menu. Now if you want to update the candidate record, then you can update the candidate record by clicking on the candidate update record button, and it will bring you to this page. So you can update all the records here. Then going back to the main menu, if you want to search any particular record, I will show you how we can search a particular record and what are the details will be shown. So upon clicking on the search record and then upon clicking on the I want to search a voter profile, a staff profile, and then upon entering the candidates, the staff ID 877889, and then searching, and then this all the details are shown here. Then upon, if you want to delete a voter or staff profile, then you can easily delete here by entering the staff ID or the voter ID, and then there's all this stuff here. So that's all about the records management application which we will design using C# programming and MySQL database, which will be the backend database. So we will create this application step by step, and hopefully you would enjoying this course, and everything will be explained in a detailed way. So if you have enjoyed this video, and if you are willing to jump into the real world programming, into the functional programming, then you can subscribe my channel and you can learn how you can create such a huge and full featured application. Next, so you would hopefully you would be enjoying the course, so kindly subscribe my channel and stay tuned. Also, you can like our Facebook page and also can become member of our Facebook group, and can also visit our blog for much more programming stuff. Thank you for watching, and wait for my next lecture. And the next lecture will be in the next lecture I will give you a detailed demo of the login form. So thank you for watching and wait for my next lecture.